Tonight, the UC Davis Aggies look to keep their home opener magic alive.
It's going to be super exciting. Love playing at the home games.
The hometown kids ready to play under the lights.
We're going to go out and do our thing.
The success behind Dan Hawkins.
Guys are capable of being All-American. We have a bunch of those guys on our football team.
Every home game, every highlight right now. Aggies All Access on My58.
We are 30 minutes from kickoff for the UC Davis Aggies home opener. Thank you for joining us. I'm Andrea Flores.
And I'm Michelle Dapper. Tonight, where the Aggies are taking on Southern Utah, the Thunderbirds. The T-Birds have yet to win a game this season, while the Aggies, they sit at 1-1. But tonight, the Aggies look to keep their home opener magic alive after learning some tough lessons from last week's 55-7 loss to 16th-ranked Oregon State.
A score aside, it's really about playing and responding to adversity and putting your best foot forward.
It's a great learning experience for us, and so now it's just going to come down to how we respond.
And how they respond is up to the players tonight, and they are led by head coach Dan Hawkins.
Coach has been leading the Aggies since 2017, earning Big Sky Coach of the Year in 2018. Now, under his leadership, the Aggies earned 10 All-Big Sky Awards. KCRA 3 Sports Director Del Rogers explains why coaching in 20 different countries is part of the madness to the success of Dan Hawkins.
Coach Hawkins took over the Aggies football program in 2017 with a plan of using his method of past success for future success at UCD.
I've had some successes in my career, and I've had a lot of failures too, and you learn from those. I really just wanted to jumpstart and get going fast, throw the ball around the yard, be fun, be exciting.
And during the past 6 years he's been here, the exciting Aggies reached the postseason twice, winning their share of a conference title in only his second year as head coach.
We were able to kind of flip it probably quicker than you normally would think. And then, you know, as a player, once you start having success, then the guys just buy in. They're all in. Like, I get it, coach. I'm with you. And once you have that, you can grab onto the oar and row pretty hard.
And with everyone in the same boat, facing and rowing in the same direction, top talent is everywhere.
Guys that are capable of being All-American. Guys that are capable of playing at the next level. We have a bunch of those guys on our football team. So a lot of talent, experience, and depth. That combined with just that next level of culture.
And to find that next level of culture, Coach Hawk felt teaching football in foreign countries would pay dividends on and off the field.
So I went to Montreal, went to Australia, but then coached in Sweden and Austria, and then we did camps and clinics and traveled to other places. And yeah, it's been great, and I love it. It's a big part of me, and that's why I want our guys to travel abroad and study and get a passport and go. We're shipping a lot of dudes out right now. It'll make the world a better place. It'll make them better people.
At UC Davis, Del Rogers for the Aggies All Access show on My58.
Well, UC Davis is ranked number one in the nation and second in the world in veterinary science and in agriculture and forestry. And the student athletes on the football team are thankful to obtain a prestigious degree of their choice at UC Davis.
Jaden Stanley, sustainable environmental design major. Designing buildings, make sure the environment is sustainable for the future to come. 10 years, I see myself maybe designing something like this beautiful health stadium, you know, something that'll be sustainable maybe for the football team.
My name is Jahal Budget, and I'm a community and regional development major. It has to do with helping out communities that are underprivileged, under-resourced, and haven't had the opportunities that other communities have had. This summer I had an internship with SMUD, working with sustainable communities. They do a lot of work in the community in Sacramento. I was happy to be able to stay home, but as well get a great degree, you know, close by. I know UC Davis is a very prestigious school, so that was a big part in why I chose this school.
Luke Van Buren, applied physics.
It's basically a physics major mixed in with a focus. Physics is kind of like kicking the rock down the road, so there's a lot of things it can stem into. I'm applying to grad school. I'm doing some internships after this. I just like learning. It's like a perfect balance between education, athletics. I don't think you can really do it anywhere else.
I'm Joey Carrillo, and I'm a biological sciences major. It covers, you know, all kind of animal and plant life. You can go in human biology. There's a lot of different routes you can go. 10 years from now, hopefully I'm in, you know, a residency, getting ready. I'm trying to be an anesthesiologist specifically, so that's, you know, a lot of school. So I'll probably still be in some sort of school. To be able to, you know, come here and get the great education on top of, you know, doing what I love out here is, yeah, really special. Not a lot of guys get to do it.
My name's CJ Hutton, and my major is managerial economics.
pretty much business. It's the closest thing because we don't have a business degree here. My mom is part of a family construction company, so I am looking to potentially go with that. And then my father is in medical sales, so potentially going into sales, setting yourself up for the future because you're not going to play football forever.
Well, you heard from a couple of local players, including Monterey Trail High School alum Jahiel Budget. We had a chance to catch up with his high school coach about his growth over the years.
Jahiel, we had his older brother in the program. Our program is not easy. It's a hard regimen of discipline and structure and accountability. And he was doing it as a little child. It's awesome to watch the transition of all the years, their progress from a child all the way to a man.
Another Monterey Trail High School alum is Andre Crump Jr. This wide receiver comes to UC Davis after some time at San Jose State. Coach Ewing says the sky is the limit for this wide receiver.
Andre has national level talent. I mean, in my opinion, Andre is as good as he wants to be. He's nothing can hold Andre back. He's strong. He's everything. He's entirely intelligent. He can pick things up really fast, learn things really quickly. I mean, he is everything.
Well, he is everything. Monterey Trail alums aren't the only local players.
There are 25 players from the greater Sacramento region representing 19 high schools. Yeah. Another school represented is Granite Bay High School, and they have three alums, Evan Tattersall, Zaire Collier, and Benjamin Newman. And we talked to their high school coaches about what it means to see the players they coached playing at the next level.
It's really rewarding to get to watch the young men go on and continue their education and continue getting the opportunity to play football. It's obviously a very difficult thing to do, and not a lot of guys get to do it. So it's special for those young men and reflective of the hard work and the time that they put in.
Have them here at Davis creates that kind of feel that they're still at home and they're playing for the home team. And then for Ben and Zaire and Evan to all go to such a great school at, like UC Davis, it makes us all very proud.
Well, the local connections don't stop with the players. KCR3 sports director Del Rogers introduces us to the local product calling the plays on offense.
And a handoff, and Larrison slashes through the line.
The man behind the exciting offensive play calling for the UC Davis Aggies is a local product in Mike Cody.
I grew up in Auburn, and I think my mom had a choice, either sending me to Placer or Colfax, and I think we ended up choosing Colfax High School. So I ended up going to Colfax High School because the bus stop went by our house.
And while playing football at Colfax High School, Cody was good enough to move on to the next level, playing 2 years at Sierra College, where he earned all-conference honors, which earned him a scholarship offer from UC Davis.
I was like, hey, Mom, I really want to go to Davis. And she was like, oh, thank God. She's like, I was so worried about the cows next to the stadium. I was like, cows? What are you talking about? Sure as heck, like, that's one of the things you really love about Davis.
And his local luck helped return Cody to his alma mater in 2020. And just 3 years later, he was promoted to offensive coordinator, where his offensive schemes change every week, depending on the complexity of their opponent's defense.
We're always trying to find out of, okay, like, hey, this week we'll attack them this way because, you know, us having a multiple offense allows us to do that.
And to be able to change up from week to week, high football IQ is a must on the Aggies' offensive side of the football.
I think it has everything to do with the players. Yeah, we're trying to plug them in and play to their strengths.
At UC Davis, Del Rogers for the Aggies' All Access Show on My58.
From offense to defense, meet the Yale graduate ready to make things complex but simple.
And UC Davis alum and announcer Scott Marsh joins us in studio. What to watch this season from the Aggies and the interesting history behind the team next on Aggies All Access on My58. The UC Davis Aggies looking to keep their home opener magic alive, a winning streak that dates back to 2016. Here's a look at those wins, and they include San Diego, Dixie State, Cal Poly, Lehigh, and Southern Oregon. UC Davis announcer Scott Marsh joins us now. Scott, what do you hope to see from the Aggies in this home opener against Southern Utah?
I hope to see 8 in a row on Saturday night, first of all, but honestly, just to get back in rhythm. It was a tough night on Saturday night at Oregon State. A great team, obviously, against the Beavers, playing Southern Utah, a team they're familiar with. home atmosphere, get the offense going.
And of course, the T-Birds, it's a little bit misleading. They haven't won a game this season, but man, they've had
pretty
some,
good.
Right. They had some success as far as, you know, taking Arizona State to the brink.
They could have won that game.
Absolutely.
24-21. Then they play at BYU the next week, 41-16. Very respectable. This is going to be a really good game because these are two teams that are really evenly matched.
Yeah. From the Aggies, 6 turnovers on the season so far.
Yeah,
4
way
in the
many.
First game. They won that game against Texas A&M Commerce.
Yeah.
And then, of course, we saw what happened with Oregon State. But how do you take care of the football?
Got to do a better job. And, you know, Miles Hastings, who was their all-conference quarterback last year, threw for over 3,000 yards, only had 6 interceptions. Well, he's got 5 turnovers in the first 2 games, 3 interceptions, 2 fumbles. He would tell you he's got to be better. He's got to protect the football.
And for the offense, sticking with that, the run game, though. Lan Larrison's been a spark plug out there this year.
More than a spark plug, we know he's a steer wrestler from Idaho. Mm-hmm. He's a high hurdler, too. He's jumping over defenders. He does everything. They call him the Christian McCaffrey of this team. He runs, he passes, he throws. He is dynamic. He's really fun to watch, Michelle.
No question. And, of course, the defense. Let's talk about that. This is probably one of their best defenses in quite some time.
I would agree. It's really deep. Up front, they're good. They've got 3 nose tackles who go 330-plus, so they can stop the run. The backers are quick. Teddy Buchanan's a 2-time captain. And at the corners, you featured Jahil Budget, the local kid from Monterey Trail. A lot of people think he's next level caliber.
It's funny, I was out there at practice this week and I was looking, and he has that eye test factor where you look at him and you're like, okay, I think this kid could
play. He looks the part.
Absolutely. Absolutely. Home openers, they're looking to keep that magic alive. What is special about Aggie Stadium or UC Davis Health Stadium now?
You know, it's just great for this level of football. It's kind of like what it is for the River Cats, right? It's just the equivalent. It's cool. It's got the grass berm so people can bring their kids out. They can walk along the whole field. They can sit down. They can have almost like a picnic-like experience. It's community day, so like the whole community is going to be there from Davis and Woodland, the outlying areas. Yep. You really get a fun family festive atmosphere out there at UC Davis.
And you love it because it's inset and it's intimate and it's fun. Great time. Go Aggies, right?
Go Aggies.
Go Aggies. All right. Well, head coach Dan Hawkins hired a Yale graduate to make things complex but simple on defense. KCRA3 sports director Del Rogers introduces us to Matt Coombs.
The defensive side of the ball is led by Matt Coombs, a 2007 Yale graduate that began coaching at the high school level and then on to the college ranks in 2016. He was then asked to join UC Davis by head coach Dan Hawkins in 2019.
He was willing to take a chance on me, and I don't know that there were many other coaches in his position that would have given me the same level of responsibility.
And under Matt Coombs, the Aggies opened their 2023 season, holding Texas A&M Commerce to a total of 10 points during the entire game.
How can we take the next step and make sure that, you know, we're winning games that we have chances to win and finish in the playoffs and making some, you know, some noise when we get there.
And to make some noise in the playoffs, Coach Coombs will play only one type of player on his defense.
I would say you've got to be willing to play physical. You have to be extremely fast, and you've got to be confident when you make a decision. And I think where guys have tough time is if they feel like they're unsure with what they're supposed to be doing or they're thinking too much, like, just go. Like, if you make a mistake, go full speed.
At UC Davis, Del Rogers for the Aggies All Access Show on My58.
Staying with the defense, linebacker Nick Eaton grew up in Rockland and went to Whitney High School.
Was always a freakish athlete. Freakish athlete with just the motor to go along with it. The kid never quit. I just remember him being so powerful, and I just remember him working so hard to become a really, really good football player. He could play any sport if he wanted to. Really, really good athlete.
Another former Wildcat is Ian Simpson, as the tight end continues to be a big part of the Whitney football community.
Being able to go to see him, you know, play local games and just being able to still have a relationship with him. I mean, he's still an ambassador for Whitney High School. I mean, he still comes by and checks out our games, you know, especially when he was at American River. He's on our sidelines and he's coming back, and he's an example that I use to have kids, you know, look up to, you know, the transformation that he's made from high school all the way to college level. And he's just somebody that is, you know, forever a Wildcat.
And finally, Justin Kraft completes the trio of Whitney players. We spoke to his high school basketball coach about his impact.
One of the best athletes I've ever had the pleasure to coach. He was a two-sport, all-league football and basketball player here at Whitney High School. Pure athlete, amazing worker, amazing young man, great kid. Always had a great attitude. He was the oldest of three Crafts kids and athletes that I was able to coach here.
The intangibles. All right, downtown Davis businesses serving up Aggie pride. When we come back, why they say having televised home games will be, of course, bring a much needed boost. Aggie football is back, and downtown Davis businesses say they're ready for the boost fans bring to bars and restaurants. And now that home games are being televised right here on My58, some owners say it's a game changer.
I graduated in 2004. I moved to Davis in 1999.
Tom Jobst is a proud UC Davis Aggie.
So we used to go down to Toomey Field. We'd come down here to Froggies at halftime, have a couple, and then maybe go back.
I'm going to start our tri-tip.
20 years later, he's now the chef and co-owner of Froggies, a longtime bar and grill on the corner of 2nd and G Streets in downtown Davis.
They got this great big stadium, and now they're going to be aired on TV, which is exciting.
Jobst is excited to have a space for local fans to watch every home game.
It's going to be really cool that they were on local TV now for everybody, not just for the city of Davis, but the entire region. You know, we used to have to find a laptop to try to stream the games for people that, you know, couldn't get tickets or couldn't go sit in the sun and everything. This is going to be great for downtown. It's good for all of us.
Down the street, Woodstock's Pizza recently opened at its new home at 3rd and G Streets.
My very first Woodstock shift was actually a football game, so I immediately have been doing like all the football games for the last 5 years, so that's been pretty fun.
Assistant manager Maricela Gloria says Woodstock's is pulling double duty, serving up slices at home games and hosting game day watch parties.
I love them so much. There's definitely a buzz of like, it is super intense. We actually just brought on in the last 3 weeks 25 new hires, just because we need the extra staff to kind of cater to all the business and go to the game.
Downtown businesses say win or lose.
You know, if we lose, it's a reason to go out and pick up our spirits. And if we win, it's a bunch of reasons to celebrate. So it's just good to be out in like downtown when there are games going on. It's a good energy to be around.
They're ready to cheer on the home team.
And yeah, we're excited for the Aggies. Go Aggs, babe. Go Aggs.
Yeah, go Hags. Well, it's a watch party, and it's not complete, of course, without the food.
Right.
At Froggies, you can indulge in the Aggie Jam burger topped with bacon jam. Sounds pretty good. And
yum.
Woodstock's is serving up the Davis Classic Pizza and the Aggie Club Sandwich. A little bit of Aggie pride served up with every order.
Can't go wrong. Mm. Go Aggs. We're just minutes away from kickoff, and the work is just beginning for this dog. Next, meet Corey, the Rocket Dog. Well, the UC Davis football team does something only four other universities in the country can say they do. They include a canine friend as part of their roster.
Pretty cool. As Jason Mark shows us, Corey, the Rocket Dog has used his jets to become a fan favorite.
Every dog should have a place to play, a place to stretch his or her legs. Three-year-old lab Corey has her place.
Corey's ready for anything.
And as you can see, her area is a bit bigger than most.
She loves to be on the field. She loves the excitement of the field.
That field belongs to UC Davis football, where Corey is an unofficial member of the team.
She does such a good job. She's super energetic. The crowd loves her.
You can train for this as much as you want, but you can't train for having 13,000 people in the stands, all of them yelling her name and knowing exactly what she's going to do. Back.
But Corey isn't on offense or defense, running back or wide receiver. She instead plays retriever.
So Corey is the second tee dog for UC Davis to retrieve the kickoff tee.
It's Corey's job after every Aggie kick to go get the tee.
Tee dog's like our best friend, you know?
Good girl, Corey.
Just ask sophomore kicker Angelo Giannetti.
It's probably the loudest the stadium gets besides a touchdown. Everyone just goes crazy for her when she runs out, and I think it's awesome.
Come on.
Corey's owner, Lisa Tell, is a professor at the university's vet school. She just knew Corey would be perfect for the job, though neither knew much about the sport.
I'll be honest, I don't know a lot about football. I'm a veterinarian. As veterinarians, we work pretty hard. We have long hours, and so I'm learning about football.
Now she cheers on the team and her fur baby every Saturday.
My kids tease me, and they say, you're prouder of the dog than you were of us.
Touchdowns equal wins. They also equal work for Corey. So as you can imagine, a lack of scoring would leave her pretty teed off.
I'll tell you, she's a pretty happy dog. She's not particular. She's just happy to be there. But I'm sure that she would like for the players to make sure that they win.
For photojournalist Brian Fong, Jason Marks, KCRA 3 News.
She is such a good girl. Well, absolutely. Corey does not just work during football season. She also serves as the for baseball games.
Yeah, she's a busy dog. All right, well, here's a look at the Aggies' upcoming schedule tonight. Again, they're taking on Southern Utah. Students will be back on campus next week as the Aggies take on Eastern Washington. Then they hit the road for Cal Poly October 7th. It's homecoming against Montana, and then Weber State on October 14th. Thank you for joining us for Aggies All Access on My58.
We'll see you tonight after the game for the KCRA 3 News at 10. Go Aggs.
Go Aggs.